Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com and upphone.com, and in this video we are going to explain what to do when your iPhone XS, XS Max, or XR is frozen.
And if it's frozen, as you know, it means that the software is crashed and is not responding to anything that you do. So the software listens to everything on the iPhone. It's called listeners, actually, to events. Events are things like you touch it, it's not working. What's the first troubleshooting step?
Well, we're going to hard reset our iPhones.
The software, right. So to hard reset an iPhone XR, XS, XS Max, you're going to tap the volume up button, tap the volume down button, and then press and hold the side button until the Apple logo appears on the screen.
Yep. Could take 20 seconds, 25 seconds. Just keep pressing and holding. Don't give up.
Yep, just keep holding. Especially if the iPhone's frozen, That means that there probably is a software issue, and it's going to take a little while for this to happen. When you see the Apple logo, you can let go, and this is when you're probably going to have fixed the problem.
Yep.
But you might want to keep on watching this video because We're going to talk about some permanent solutions.
Yeah, I mean, we fixed the temporary problem, but there's still a deeper underlying software issue
there's
on your iPhone that hasn't been resolved.
Mm-hmm.
So right now that your iPhone is 99% of your iPhones are back on, make sure to save a backup right now, whether it's iTunes or iCloud.
Mm-hmm.
We have a video on how to backup your iPhone to iCloud. We'll link that in a card above in the description section below. And we have a great article on how to backup your iPhone to iTunes and pay it forward, and we'll link to that as well.
Super important.
Just plug it into a computer, click on your phone, click backup now. Pretty simple.
So there are two main software things that we can take a look at. One is the iPhone's operating system itself, or iOS, which is kind of like the parent. And then there are all the little apps that run on your iPhone. Apps aren't supposed to be able to crash your entire iPhone, but I've seen it happen before if one gets out of control and starts hogging up all the resources, Especially if it's not an app that was developed by some big company.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes apps get outdated. Apple's supposed to be perfect, but in truth, apps crash. So if every time you open an app, your iPhone gets slow, or if you know what that app is, you might have a feeling about what this problem is, delete the app. If you can find a different one, that's great. Mm-hmm. If not, just reinstall the app from the App Store. And sometimes just doing that will fix the problem. Let's say it's not an app, though.
Let's say it's not an app. Well, then we should reset all settings and try to eliminate that software problem wherever it may be.
Yep, so this is the easiest version of solving an iOS software problem.
Yep, so we're going to open the Settings app. We're going to scroll down and tap General. Scroll all the way down to Reset. Tap Reset All Settings, and then tap Reset All Settings again. I won't do it now because I don't want to reset all my settings, because That's a pain in the butt.
It's not too big of a deal. I mean, like it erases all like your wallpaper and
Wi-Fi passwords, Bluetooth devices. Right. So I mean, it's not that big of a deal, but it's a little bit of work to set your iPhone back up. It takes 5 to 10 minutes to set your iPhone back up.
Right, and now we're going to talk about the big hammer, as I used to call it. It's kind of a stupid name. For the DFU Restore, which is a device firmware update, and it's the deepest type of restore that you can do on an iPhone. A DFU Restore erases everything on your iPhone first, so as David said, make sure you have a backup, And then it puts it all back on again. If you go to an Apple store with a hardware problem, they're going to try to DFU Restore your iPhone before they're going to give you a replacement, because they think they know everything.
Right.
I'm just kidding.
We
didn't know everything.
We do have a great DFU Restore walkthrough. We'll link to that in the description section below and a card up above. If the DFU Restore doesn't fix the problem, there might be a hardware issue with your iPhone, especially if you water damage, a big one, freezes your iPhone.
I don't know what happened to my phone.
You're kind of in trouble there.
Right.
But if you do have a broken iPhone, Upphone is a great resource to get a new one.
Upphone is our new cell phone comparison site. It's like the Travelocity of cell phones. I've been saying that lately. You can compare every phone and every plan in the US online and find one that works for you. You can also take a look at deals, and you might be able to save a lot of money. If you want to have a great plan and a great carrier, sometimes you'd have to pay a lot more with that carrier, but you can find other carriers that use their networks. There's a lot there. It's kind of cool.
I mean, if you're not interested in getting a new phone, take your frozen iPhone into Apple and see what they can do. If they can't do anything,
might be time for a new phone.
Might be time for a new phone.
Yep, check it out.
So that's what to do when your iPhone XS, XS Max, or XR is frozen. Thank you guys for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Leave us a comment down below. Let us know what you think. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the notifications bell to get an immediate update when we upload a new video.